Today, in this video, let us discuss the questions and answers and some of the concepts of reflection and refraction of class 10th CBSE. The first question is, define the principal focus of a concave mirror. We know that when the light rays pass in parallel to the principal axis, after reflection, they meet at a particular point on the principal axis. And this point is only known as principal focus. You can see here all the rays are coming parallel to this principal axis, which is nothing but a line joining the pole and center of curvature. After reflection, they will be passing through a particular point, and that is only known as focus. Let us visualize the same by doing an activity. So here I have taken a concave surface and I allowed some laser rays through a laser ray box. Now you can visualize the focus. You would have observed that all the rays are meeting at this particular point, and that is only known as focus. The radius of curvature of a spherical mirror is 20 cm. What is its focal length? We know that the relation between radius of curvature and focal length is r is equal to 2f. Therefore, it is given that 20 cm is radius of curvature. Therefore, half of it should be the focal length. So, 10 cm. Name a mirror that can give an erect and enlarged image of an object. The answer is concave mirror when the object is kept in between the pole and focus. Of course, convex mirror always gives erect, but it is diminished, and plane mirrors will give the same size of the object. The next question, why do we prefer a convex mirror as rear view mirror in vehicles? In vehicles, we wanted to see the erect image, that is the first condition. Second condition, we wanted to see a larger field view. So these are the two conditions fulfilled by the convex mirror. So we use it as a rear view mirror. Now, the next question, find the focal length of convex mirror whose radius of curvature is 32 cm. This is again the same problem, r is equal to 2f, therefore f is equal to r by 2, so answer would be 32 by 2, 16. And here, as it is the convex mirror, it should have the positive focal length according to new Cartesian sign conventions. Now, the next question, a concave mirror produces 3 times magnified real image of an object placed at 10 cm in front of it. Where is the image located? This question can be done directly. We know that the magnification is equal to minus V by U. Therefore, when U is equal to 10, magnification is given as 3. Therefore, V must be equal to 3 times U, that is 3 times 10 cm, which is equal to 30 cm. Now, the next question, a ray of light traveling in air enters obliquely into water, does the light ray bend towards the normal or away from the normal, and why? We know that the speed of light in denser medium is lesser than that of speed of light in rarer medium. Here, air is rarer medium and water is denser medium. The speed of the light ray is decreased when it goes from air to water. Therefore, it comes towards the normal. Next, light enters from air to glass having refractive index 1.50. What is the speed of light in the glass? The speed of light in vacuum or air is 3×10⁸ meter per second. We know the formula for refractive index is speed of light in the first medium by the speed of light in the second medium. So here the refractive index is given as 1.50. Remember, refractive index is purely a number, it does not have any units. So by applying the formula for refractive index, speed of light in vacuum by speed of light in air, because here air is the first medium. So now let us substitute the values. After substituting, if you calculate, it gives us the speed of light in water as 2×10⁸ meter per second. Here the important concept is the formula for refractive index, speed of light in first medium by the speed of light in second medium. Find from table. So for that we require table. Let's have the table which is having the highest optical density, also find with lowest optical density. So to find the optical denser medium, we must see the refractive index. When do you say that any medium is optically denser? If the speed of light is lesser in that particular medium, we call it as optically denser medium. And if the speed of light is more, then we say that is optically rarer medium. Of course, you cannot label any medium as denser or rarer. It is purely a relative concept. For example, if you compare the water with air, it becomes denser medium. And if the same water is compared with the glass, it becomes rarer medium. So from the table, it is clearly visible that highest refractive index is diamond 2.42. Therefore, it is highest optical, having highest optical density, and the lowest one is air 1.0033. Therefore, it is the lowest optical denser medium. Now, the next question, you are given kerosene, turpentine, and water. In which of these does the light travel fastest? We have just discussed that if the refractive index is more, the speed of light is lesser. If the refractive index is less, then speed of light is more. So when from the table, the previous table, refractive index of kerosene is 1.44, turpentine is 1.47, and that of water is 1.33. So as the refractive index of water is lesser among these three given media, so the light would travel fast in water and obviously in kerosene it is lesser. The speed of light will be very less when compared to the remaining two media. Here one point I would like to highlight: the physical density of water is more than that of kerosene. How do you test? If you take a test tube and suppose if you put kerosene of some drops, and after that if you put water, the water goes and settles at the bottom and kerosene comes on the top of it. So it clearly indicates that the kerosene physical density is lesser than that of physical density of water. But the speed of light when it is observed in kerosene, it is lesser, and speed of light in water, it is more. Therefore, This is an exceptional case. In some of the media only, the physical density has nothing to do with the optical density. So optical density, how do you find? If the speed of light is lesser, then it comes under denser medium. And if the speed of light is more, it comes under rarer medium. Again, it is a relative measurement. No medium can be labeled as optically denser medium or optically rarer medium. Now, the refractive index of diamond is 2.42. What is the meaning of this statement? We know that refractive index is directly telling us the information about the speed of light in that particular medium. So, when we compare the speed of light, it tells us that the speed of light in diamond is 1 by 2.42 times the speed of light in air. I have wrongly written this. It should have been air. We are comparing the speed of light in air and other media. In other words, we can say the speed of light in air or vacuum is 2.42 times the speed of light in diamond. When we indicate the refractive index as 2.42, it is with reference to air only. So here, this is not water, of course, this is air only. Next, define one diopter of power of lens. So diopter is the power of lens whose focal length is 1 meter. Diopter is the SI unit, or we can say 1 by meter or meter minus 1 is also the SI unit of the power. What do you understand by power? Power can be mathematically defined as the reciprocal of focal length expressed in meters, or otherwise it is the degree of divergence or convergence of that particular lens. Power for convex lens is always positive and power for concave lens is negative. Now, a convex lens forms a real and inverted image of a needle at a distance of 50 centimeters from it. Where is the needle placed? In front of the convex lens. If the image is equal to the size of the object, we know that when in the case of convex lens, when the object is placed at 2f, twice the focal length, the image is also obtained at the same distance on the other side of the lens. So the answer would be 50 centimeters only. So here, when it is 50 centimeters, then the focal length is equal to 25 centimeters. Therefore, the power of a lens can be written as 1 by 25 by 100, which is equal to 4D. Find the power of concave lens of focal length 2 meter. So just now we have discussed power is the reciprocal of the focal length when it is expressed in meter. Of course, it is already expressed in meter here. It is given as 2 meter. Therefore, 1 by 2, which is equal to 0.5 diopters. And here, this concave, therefore, it should be negative.